Welcome to Savvy IT Solutions. In this video, very interesting topics are covered in this. Why? Because most of the web pages are looking in the same direction. That is navigation bar. We need to create a menu with the help of navigation bar and image gallery. We are also making an image into a gallery style. So these two are the most important topics in web technologies. Why? Because most of the web pages are more beautiful because of navigation bar and image gallery. So let us move into the session. So the initially we are discussing about navigation bar, and secondly image gallery will be discussed. Okay, so the navigation bars, having easy to use navigation is important for any website. With CSS you can transform boring HTML menus into good looking navigation bars. Navigation bar is equal to list of links. A navigation bar needs standard HTML as a base. In our examples, we will build the navigation bar from a standard HTML list. A navigation bar is basically a list of links. So using li and ul and li elements makes perfect sense. So now ul, unordered list, list type style is none. Margin is 0, padding is 0, and overflow is hidden. Already we discussed overflow is hidden means it comes in the side by side. Okay, list float is equal to left, means left side. The menu or align in left. Somebody will give center. Okay, now a link a visited. Whenever we are clicking on the link or when the link is visited, the display is block. And width is 120px, font width is bold, color is white, background color is so and so, text align is center, padding is given, text decoration is given, text decoration none, text transform uppercase. Whenever we are typing lowercase text also, it changes to uppercase. That is what exactly it takes. So when we mouse over or it is an active link, just the background color changed. Only this background color is changed from when mouse over or active. Okay, let us move. So when we are using it ul li, so the link will be given. So actually here we need to provide a link name, links of the other HTML pages, but here I am not using properly. Okay, so home, news, contact, about. See here, first letter is the capital and remaining is small, but it changes to capital letter. So the reason is, so here I am using text transformation is uppercase. So the second one is, here we need to give active links automatically. Whenever we are clicking on home, automatically it moves to index.html, news.html, contact.html and about.html will be moved. So the menu will be coming in a very neat way. Okay. So when I am practically explaining you in detail, I will explain you how the menus are working. Okay, now second one is image gallery. This is the most important, and students are so very much like to do some activities related to image. To create more look and feel using divs, so div image, when I am using in divisions, image is the tag. So margin is 5px, padding is 5px, border 1px, solid so and so color, height is auto, width is auto, float is left, and text align is center. Okay, div image, again image, image internal another image, display inline, margin is 5px, border is 1px, solid and white color. Okay, div image, mouse over, and image, border 1px, solid, so and so white color. Div description, we need to also give description to the image. So text align center, text weight is normal, width is 120px, margin is 5px. First I will show you the output, then go to this. This is the first outer layer, and this is the inner layer, and this is the text, this is the text description, this is the inner image, and this is the outer layer. So here the gap is the cell spacing, cell padding, everything should be used. Now coming to the part, div class is equal to image, the class name is image, at the target image is arif. So same blank we are giving it. So next src, I am using image. Okay, alternative text, if the image is not properly imported, then we are giving alternative text. Width and height is common to us. So similarly, div class is called description, I am adding the description here. Go through it once. Div image, these are the properties. Obviously the border will be created. Div image, image, here we are not using it. So coming to the part A, anchor tag is used for navigating, and the second one is description to give the more information about the image will be described. So this is what remaining four also working in the same. See, you can see class is equal to image and anchor tag up to here, and in the this inner image is used. Okay, and the description, same things will be repeated. See, this is the anchor tag and this is the inner image, this is the anchor tag. So simply when I am clicking image, automatically the respective page will be opened. Okay, so here I am using herif hash, means the same page will be repeatedly opened. There is no new page will be opened. If we are specifying any link, automatically the link will be navigated to next page. That is what exactly we are making into its sense. So this is the output. So most of the company board members profiles are looking like this. So I will show you how best we need to do it. First I will explain this example. Apart from this, I will also show you some changes how we need to make it. So here we are using rectangle shape. Next onwards we are using same place, we are using circle. So already we discussed how to make a circle. So using that circle mechanism here itself. So the next one is image opacity and transparency. Image opacity and transparency, the property for transparency is opacity. First we will show you how to create a transparent image with CSS. So this is a way the transparent image will be look like, means the image is backgroundly working. Okay, so the opacity I am using some value, and filter alpha opacity means actually the opacity, this is the entire part is filter alpha opacity 30. Okay, automatically it goes. So image is used with automatically, when I am using image, automatically this will be coming. Okay, so the next challenge is when I am mouse over to this, automatically it will be active, clear image will be shown. So in this scene, when I am mouse over, this image will be shown like this. When the mouse is not over, the image will be shown like this. This is also one of the important task. So the opacity is 0.4, I will take it, and when I am mouse over, the opacity changed to 1. So the values are in between 0.0 to 1.0, we are using the opacity. So here 1.0 is used, automatically it is normal image. When I am mouse over, automatically the changes will be happened. Okay, now the next one is transparency text. I will show you the output, then go back. So background image followed by a trans opacity under this the text, means now you can see most of the websites are carousels are moving, means the images are sliding here. So on that sliding, the texts are displayed like this. That is the reason we are explaining this part here. So div background, I am using background URL so and so. Image here, I am, instead of using colors or others, I used this. I am also using repeat. Repeat X or Y, or repeat means both the sides it will be repeated. Border we are giving it. Okay, next div trans box. So already this transparency box is created. The transparency box will be created with margin is 30px, background color is white, border is 1px, and opacity is 0.6. okay, that's why the above box will come. Next transparent box, p is the p tag. Okay, So here margin is 5%, font weight is bold and color is white, color is black. So now I am using background transparent box p tag. Obviously this what type of look will be coming. Okay, thank you.